Hi, my name's Jared, and in this bootcamp tutorial, we're going to look into liquid value stocks. Value stocks are underpriced assets, normally according to the book value of the company. We're going to use Morningstar fundamental data to filter and select that universe and pick liquid assets to trade. This is going to be a long-short strategy, so we're going to buy stocks which have a good value and short stocks which are overpriced or might be losing money. So let's jump into it. QuantConnect offers fine fundamental data, which is provided by Morningstar. It's got approximately 900 different properties for each company in the dataset, and you can select this as the second stage of a filter. First, though, you need to do the first stage, which we've covered already, which is coarse universe selection. Coarse universe selection, you're able to filter down by the dollar value of the stock or the volume of the stock. Here we're going to set up our universe module to lay the foundation for the future tasks. And here we want to select an empty coarse method and then an empty fine method. So let's use the example code here. And you'll note here that we're returning universe unchanged because we haven't set the filters yet. And we need to create an instance of it and add it to the algorithm. And it's a little detail here, but it says set your universe settings to request hourly resolution data. So let's do that too. Okay. Let's see how we go. Okay, great. On to the next task. Now, this is the real meat of the bootcamp. Fine fundamental is the second stage in a two-stage filter. You've got 8,000 different assets that come into the universe and go through the coarse selection. First, you need to select the assets which have a liquid enough to be able to trade. And then secondly, once you've got those assets, we can go and load the fine fundamental data for them and then provide you that data to generate another filter. We want to be doing the selection based on the dollar volume. And a lot of the work's done for you here. But if we can just review it, so you can see here we are sorting by the dollar volume. And we're taking all of the coarse objects, and first we're checking if it has fundamental data. As a way to reduce the work that we do later, you can check if the company has fundamental data, and then go and sort by the dollar volume. And then finally here we're saying we want to return a list of the symbols in the top 100 by dollar volume. Now we skipped over step one here. A lot of fundamental data only changes once per month. So, for example, a company only releases their earnings every 3 months, every quarter. So there's no point in doing this universe selection every single day as it's quite computationally expensive. This is a little trick to just speed up the algorithm. You can look at the algorithm time and detect if the month has changed. And if the month hasn't changed, it's the same month as last month, then we'll just return the universe unchanged, which says, I'm okay, we don't need to redo this analysis. Let's paste this in here. Long term, we're looking to get a scheduled universe function, but this is here for today. And submit that one and see how we go. So you can see here the backtest is taking just a minute to run. So underneath the hood, we're actually loading a lot of data. Now it's completed, we can move on to the next phase, using our fundamental data. Underneath this first filter, there's another one. You first do the coarse selection based on the price and the volume, and then you can go and do the fine selection based on Morningstar data. Morningstar data has a lot of different properties, and you probably want to go to the documentation and have a look. It's under documentation, data, and then fundamental. And then you can look up each of these and really understand each one before you use it. For example, here we've got the yield And you can see here that for each fine object, we have this valuation ratios property and then the earning yield property. And then here we're reversing the sort because the higher your earning yield, the better. But then it's exactly the same piece of data, but the price earnings ratio is the opposite way around. It's the inverse of the earnings yield, so you need to reverse sort it. So it's a very subtle distinction you might want to go and look into later, but it's important to know what you're doing when you're using fundamental data. Here, we'll paste this one in. And we're doing a sort on the entire fine universe, which comes in based on the earnings yield. Earnings yield is the percentage return per stock. So if you have earnings per share, which is say 10 cents, and if the stock price was a dollar, the earnings yield would be 10%. Here we're sorting that so that the highest earning yield stocks are at the top. And then we want to do a slice to take the top and the bottom of this universe. Okay, so here we've got our sorted fine objects. And you see we're taking the top, and then we're also taking the very bottom of that list. So presumably these are stocks which are losing money and have a low earning yield. And finally, now we have this self.universe, which is the collection of fine objects. Fine filters are just like coarse filters. You need to return the list of symbols. So on each fine object, we have the symbol property. So you can see here, it's going over each fine object and extracting that symbol object to return it from the method. So we paste that in here. And now you can see it's going to sort our fine objects, take the top and the bottom, and then extract the symbol from that list. Let's see how we go. Okay, cool. So we've selected a long and short universe. The next step is we need to emit some insights. We've got the universe of assets, but we haven't actually placed any trades. First, we're going to create an long-short earning yield alpha model. So we need to set that to our initialize and then populate the alpha model down here. First step is initialize the algorithm. Okay, great. Now, second, just like before, we want to make sure that we're not emitting too many insights. So in this case, we're going to scan for the time, just like we did before, and only emit insights if the month has changed as well. This is just a little trick to reduce the amount of insights. And then finally, we now have a universe. We need to be able to generate insights that are appropriate for those securities. So we're going to use the fundamentals property of the security. Alpha models and universe models have to be kept completely separate, but there are some pieces of data that get passed through the framework. On the security object, there's a fundamentals property, and this has all of the Morningstar data that's available for that asset. Just keep in mind, though, that this data is only available when you do a fine universe selection. If you've just got a manually created universe, you're not going to see the Morningstar data there. In this case, we're actually going to be looking to see if the earnings yield is greater than zero. Otherwise, we're going to be shorting it. So let's copy our helper here. Paste that in down here. Let's go through this in a little more detail. For each security in the algorithm active security.values, the algorithm has an active securities collection that's stored on the algorithm object. This is all of the securities which are currently in the universe. Once the assets are returned, the symbols are returned from the universe model, behind the scenes, QuantConnect goes and gets the data for those assets and puts them onto your algorithm. You can see a list of those active securities here. So now that we know that these are securities which have been selected by our universe, we can then go and check their fundamental data and check our signal, in this case it's earnings yield, and then emit in the direction of that earnings yield. The security also has the symbol property, which makes it easy for us to emit these insights. Okay, now let's see how we go. So strictly speaking, if this was to be a perfectly long, short, neutral alpha, you'd want to make sure that you emit the same number of up insights as you down insights. But in this case, it's actually doing just whether or not the earnings yield is greater than zero. So it's a loose approximation. But if there is a company which is losing money, it's going to short that asset. Okay, great. Congratulations, you've passed the Liquid Value Bootcamp video tutorial. Thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.